channels. This is a Revit magic and tricks. In this tutorial, we will talk about how to do a family scatter in Revit using the Dynamo plugin. As you probably know, placing a certain family in a Revit on a regular surface can be frustrating. It would take us a long time to make a forest like this on the render you see, unless the family is set up to recognize the surface on which it is being put. Using a very short script in Dynamo, we can easily solve this problem, so let's go to the Revit. If you haven't used Dynamo so far, it's in the Manage tab. And right in the Visual Programming section, we have the Dynamo and the Dynamo Player. I will explain the details of Dynamo and its player in the future videos. For now, we'll just launch the Dynamo. When we open Dynamo, we go to the New button and a new script file will open. Dynamo always opens in the separate window, so that if you have two monitors, you can switch to another to easy viewing. What matters is that Dynamo runs only through Revit. We can't run it separately, and if it crashes, Revit will crash as well. We will talk about Dynamo itself and all the tools and how they are used in another video. Now let's just make a really short script by following my instructions. We will first turn off the automatic running of the script and switch to manual, meaning that the script will only run after we press the run button. And one more thing you need to adjust. In tab settings, go to geometry scaling and switch to large so that your working range is between 0.01 and 1 million, and go to apply. On the left side is a search bar where you can type to find any tool in Dynamo that we see within these categories, or you right click in the workspace and type select point, and Dynamo will offer us a tool select point on face. And this is the first node we will use, and now we can control C, control V, and copy, let's say, 5 of these nodes, so that we have 5 points that we will choose from the surface. To be a neater, we can compare them in the column. What we see here now is that we have some input, in this case to choose a point, and the output given by this node, in this case, is the selected point. Then right click again and type list, and select list create. In this node consists of multiply inputs and one output. We now need to link all these points into one common list of points, which means that as many points we have, that same number we need to have inputs on this list. Pressing the plus button adds how much input we need to for this node. When we click on the output button, this wire appears and asks us to connect the other ends to some inputs. We will simply connect this end of the wire to the input and do that for all points. Now go to right click and type family types and select this node and when we click on its input we have a list of all families that are in the Revit project where we work. and we miss the last node, right click and type family by point, and select node by point. When we select that node, we can see that we have two inputs. The first is the family type, where we choose which family to choose and to which place or point we want to place it. Wherever the point is, there will be a family placed with its initial coordinate. And now we merge the family type and merge the list of points. And this is our whole script now. To use it later, we can save it and save it under some of our names. Now we can always use it. Minimize the window, and now we will see how to use it. When we click on any point input and click select, Dynamo gives us the ability to move to Revit with the mouse. When we go to the Revit, it will recognize every surface within the project. In that way, we can click and select a point on any surface in Revit. We can now see that the node is no longer yellow and contains the selected point and its ID number. Point selection in Revit can be done in any view in Revit, and now we connect all points. Now, if we click on the Run button, the script will run. We can see that the last node turned to yellow, which means that there is some kind of script error. We can see here family point by instance operation failed. It says parameter name family type. When we go back to the beginning, we can see that we have not brought in any of families we want Dynamo to place at these points. We will now select one family of trees from the list. Or we go to Revit, select on the one tree, and on the properties we can see that name, and go back to Dynamo and find that name in this list. If we now run the script again, in Revit we can see that the trees are placed in this exact places we choose by selecting the points. If we want to add more trees now, what is very important to know is that the script is still open with the selected points, each having its own ID number. So if we reselect a point and run the script, it won't make a new family, but it will move the original one to the new place. But if we want to save imported families to selected position, we will shut down Dynamo and not save. That is very important, because we are already saved the script and saved it clean without any inputs. If we want to add new trees, we will start the Dynamo again. Select the script we have already used and see that it is a clean script with no input. Now we can choose to save another family of trees and again select all the points where we want this tree to be. What you need to know is that this script works for any family. Casework, furniture, plantings, generic model, or any family that does not search for its host, such as doors, windows, and more. We will now repeat this process several times to make our first Revit forest. If you like this video, please subscribe this channel, get some like, and if you have any questions, feel free to leave a comment below. I will answer your question. In the next video, we will improve this script so that the family rotates itself at random angle to give a more natural look to the forest. See you next time.